one Swedish made peanut enlarger pump.
That's not mine.
One credit card receipt for Swedish made enlarger signed by Austin Powers.
I'm telling you, baby, that's not mine. I don't even know what this is. This sort of thing ain't my bag, baby.
One book, Swedish made enlarger pumps and me. This sort of thing is my bag, baby. By Austin Powers.
Well, that's not my bag either. Welcome to Flynn Dog Woodwork. Today, I've got five tools that are my bag. These are five crazy tools that I think might interest you. So let's not waste any time and see if any of these tools suit your needs. So finding crazy tools is something that I love to do, and today is no exception. I can honestly say that I've never seen any of these tools we're gonna take a look at. So are these tools that you're gonna be using on a daily basis? Well, some of them might. However, I was more intrigued by the unique design, and that's why I think it's important to take a look at them. So let's not waste any more time and dig into our first tool. So our first tool today is a tool that has nothing to do with precision and accuracy. In fact, I'm not even sure we'll use it in our shop. In fact, a lot of people may even consider this a yard tool. However, I have some project ideas that I think this tool will help with. So have you ever seen projects like this? This is something that I've always wanted to try, and this tool will be a key component to getting the material I need. So what is this tool? Well, let's get into it. So this tool is the Taranzi handheld chainsaw. Let's get into this box and see what it's all about. So first off, I want to say that this tool comes with more accessories than I've seen come with a tool in a long time. Let me show you what comes in this box. So first and foremost comes the cordless handheld chainsaw, but that's just the beginning. So obviously you get a user manual with this tool, but along with that you get two batteries as well as a charger. It also comes with some grip gloves, which I think is a little bit dangerous to use with this tool. There's also a screwdriver, some chain oil, some safety goggles, as well as an extra chain. Along with this, as a thank you, you also get a credit card size multi-tool, which might be kind of nice to throw in your wallet. But let's dig into this chainsaw and see how well it actually works. Now you may be a little bit concerned about having a battery operated chainsaw. However, I've had this one from Ryobi for about 5 years and I've never had a problem with it.
What are you doing? Turn that chainsaw off!
Not a chance, Lois. You know how hard it was to get that thing started?
And it's because of this that I think it's worth giving a small handheld device like this a look. Now there's not a whole lot of bells and whistles to this tool. The one thing that I did notice is there's a little lock near the trigger where you can lock it into place just to make sure that you don't mistakenly pull that trigger. But if you've ever had a battery operated chainsaw, you probably already know you should never, and I mean never, leave that battery installed in that chainsaw unless you're actively using it. So if we take apart this chainsaw, we can see how this tool actually works. There's a little gear at the very end that rotates the blade. There's also a little bolt that allows you to tighten and loosen the blade depending on what you're cutting. Now with the blade reinstalled, let's talk about what we need to do to this tool to start making some cuts. Now if you've ever owned a chainsaw, you know you're going to need some chain oil. Now I know I said earlier that this tool comes with chain oil, however it's just a container to hold that oil. So you'll lift that blade guard and generously apply some oil to that chain. With that chain oil applied, let's go ahead and add that battery and go outside and make some cuts. So with that battery installed, we can make cuts up to about 6 inches in diameter. I've got a piece of wood that's 3 inches thick, so let's cut right through that. Now if we take a look at the cookie I just cut,
cookie! Ah!
You can see it was very easy to get through that 3-inch piece of firewood. And the cut is almost as clean as what you would get off a bandsaw. So if you're looking to cut down some small trees or some larger branches, this may be the tool for you. I'm gonna use this to get the raw material to make that tabletop I've always wanted to make. Well, I'm pretty pleased with that first item. I think it's got a lot of potential to help me out with some future projects. Now that we've taken a look at our first item, let's move on to the second. Next up on today's list is a safety item that I think I've been talking about way too much on this channel. Don't know what safety tool I'm talking about? Well, I talked to this guy again, my boy Birdman. And he was chirping away once again about another damn featherboard. And he assured me that I didn't have this one, at least not this exact one. He knew I already had a weird relationship with the hedgehog featherboard, so when he saw this next item, he thought of me. So what exactly is this next item? Well, let's go check it out. So this next item is the mini hedgehog. This is made for router tables and table saws. Let's unbox this and see what it's all about. So inside the box, you'll get two mini hedgehog featherboards. And the idea with these featherboards is to give you the same support over at the router table that you get from its larger cousin over at the table saw. Unlike the big dog, which slides into a miter slot with its miter bar, this little guy slides into T-track with the little T-bolt. And the nice thing about getting two of these in a set is you can use them in tandem with each other. So you can use two of them like this to give you support on the side as well as the top of your workpiece. Or you can use them consecutively so you can get all the support you need right on the top of your workpiece. And that's the type of support that I appreciate when doing things like dados over at the router table. It's also nice to have that support when you can't get the grip you want as you push your lumber through that router table. And just like with the larger hedgehogs, these are easy to adjust on the fly. You simply loosen the knob, place your new stock in, and tighten them down. Now there's also an accessory you can purchase for these two smaller featherboards that allow you to stack them on top of each other to give you a little bit higher support. Now these are advertised that they'll work with a table saw. However, unless you're dealing with a jig that has T-track on it, I don't think these will work, as these have T-bolts and they won't fit into your standard miter slot. But if you're looking for safe and easily adjustable support over at your router table, these things have you covered. Well, that takes us through our first two items. Before we move on to our third, I ask you to do me a huge favor, hit that subscribe button, leave a like, and leave a comment. It really does help out this small woodworking channel. Also, for all the tools we're taking a look at today, I'll leave links in the description below so you can go check out these tools for yourself. Now let's move on to our third item. So if you shop on Amazon, I'm sure you've seen this next product, as they're spending a fortune on that site marketing this item. And I'll be honest, I've been ignoring those ads for a long time, but since I have this channel, I thought I'd get one just so that we can all check it out. So what is this tool? Well, let's go see if one will drop out of the sky. I'm not seeing one over here. Ugh. Here it is. This is the fouframe foldable level. Let's unbox this and see what it's all about. So this is the fouframe level, and the nice thing about this level is it's completely collapsible. This thing will collapse to 4 inches deep by 6 inches wide. And frankly, the reason that I hesitated on purchasing this level is I thought it was kind of a gimmick. It's very nice that you can collapse it and put it in your toolbox, but will this thing be level once you spread it out? So let's unravel this thing and see if it's actually level. So with the level fully extended, it goes out about 28 and a half inches long. If we look at a bird's eye view of this level, you can see there's four angle level bubbles. There's two 180s, one 90 degree, as well as a 45 degree bubble. If we look at the edge of this level, you can see there's magnets running down the entire length of the level. But let's talk about the construction of this level. With all the little hinges, I was a little bit concerned if you put any pressure on the edges of this level, there would be a little bit of flex. And by putting some pressure on this level, I'm quite surprised at how sturdy this level is. So here I've attached the level to my table saw, which is one of the flattest surfaces in my shop. Let's shine a light behind this level to see if we see any gaps. So obviously you're gonna see some light shine through at each one of these hinges, but I can tell you from just eyeballing it, each one of these segments is firmly attached to the table saw. Here I'll take my light and shine it through, and you'll see there's no light in between each one of these segments. When we take a look at my new level when comparing it to my most used level, which is this Empire level, you can see it's just a little bit longer. It also has one more angle level bubble just to give you a little bit more flexibility. Now another feature that this level claims is important is the ability to wrap it around things like corners.
I think I'll do a wrap around. Wrap around, wrap around.
Now this is a feature that I'm not quite sure I've had a need for, but you can easily wrap it around any corner and see whether or not each side is level. I suppose this might be helpful if you're doing things like framing or putting up pictures in your house. But for woodworking, I don't see a specific need for that. Maybe you have an idea, so leave a comment below. Now, the next thing you may be asking is, would you use this for setup? And I think this thing is accurate enough to make sure that your infeed and outfeed table over at your planer are completely flat. But obviously, the most important feature of this tool is the ability to fold it down and put it in your toolbox. Well, I'm pretty impressed with this tool. All my initial concerns about this tool being a little bit flexible and not being accurate enough, I think I've disproven. And if you work out of a toolbox and you don't want to carry around a long level, this might be the solution for you. Well, that covers three items so far today. Now let's take a look at our fourth item, which claims to be bionic. So I know you've all experienced this before, but you want to tighten down a bolt and you go to grab a wrench and it's either too big or too small. What if they made a wrench that could accommodate any size bolt? For me, that would save a lot of headache. If I were able to carry around one wrench for all my bolts, I would be a happy man. Well, that's what this next item claims to do. Let's see if it lives up to its reputation. So this next tool is the 8-inch bionic wrench. Let's open it up and see what it can do. So this next tool was featured in Popular Mechanics and really is quite an ingenious design. If I squeeze the handles together, you can see how this tool will engage with the bolt. So here you can see I've got two different size nuts as well as a lag screw. And you can see how this tool easily adjusts to each one of these items very quickly. Not only is this tool easily adjustable, but it also has a nice firm rubber grip that feels good on the hand. If we look at this chart here, you can see that this tool can accommodate 1/2 inch all the way up to 3/4 inch. If you're in metric, it can go from 12 millimeters all the way up to 20 millimeters. So by my calculations, that's 14 wrenches in one tool, which is really quite amazing. So if you're looking to eliminate some tools in your toolbox or just stop the guessing game, this might be the tool for you. Not to mention, this has a lifetime warranty and is made in the USA. Well, that covers four items so far today. Only one more left to take a look at. Now, this next tool or gadget is one that I know I'll use. So it's summertime here in Indiana, and by having a shop that doesn't have any air conditioning, there's one thing that I can guarantee you. And that's that I'm gonna be hot and I'm gonna need a cold beverage. And because of this, I've got a fridge in my shop filled with cold beverages. But the problem is, I've got a shop filled with cast iron surfaces. And if you know anything about a cold drink on a hot day, you know that that drink's gonna have all sorts of condensation.
Previously on condensation.
Ellen, there's moisture on the outside of my glass.
It's condensation, Johnny.
And condensation will almost immediately create rust on those cast iron surfaces. So I was curious and I Googled deep just to see if there was anything like a shop coaster. And believe it or not, I found one. This is a coaster that not only protects those cast iron surfaces, but also doubles as a tool. So let's check this little guy out. So this is a 2-pack of benchtop coasters. Let's unbox this and see what it's all about. So this 2-pack of coasters is made by Sunco. And you can see from the bottom of this coaster, it's got 4 rubber feet to protect your surfaces. It also has a variety of tools that we'll take a closer look at. So first off, it's got a bottle opener on it, which is great to open those cold beverages. But not only does it have a bottle opener, but it also has hex wrenches running down the entire side. You can also see there's a ruler in centimeters as well as inches on the opposite side. If we look at the bottom of this tool, you can see there's an eyeglass screwdriver, a wire cutter, as well as some spoke wrenches. If we look at the side that has the ruler in inches, you can see there's little holes for dividers. There's also a butterfly wrench at the very bottom. Alongside of that, each corner either has a flathead screwdriver or an opener or cutter. So let's be honest, am I going to use any of those tools? Probably not. However, is this a fun little gadget to have in your shop to protect those cast iron surfaces? Absolutely. And for me, that's what woodworking is all about, having a little fun in your shop. Well, thanks for joining me today on checking out these 5 items from my shop. I know I really enjoyed showing them to you. If you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button, leave a like, and leave a comment. It really does help out this small woodworking channel. Until next time, take care as always.